Hello and welcome back to Twinstrology. This is Marla, and today I'm going to do a timeless message from your person reading. So anytime you find this message, you can get a answer from it. And all you need to do is pick card number 1, 2, or 3, and then look below in the timestamps to find your reading. Okay, if you picked card number 1, the first message from your person is shadow aspect. So the first thing that they want you to know is that they're facing some kind of inner shadow. And this is something that's held them back. It's kind of kept them in some kind of metaphorical prison. But it is a number 5. So this person is trying to change this situation at this time. Let's see if we can find out more information about what is this shadow aspect. Okay, openness. So the thing that this person is dealing with is trying to be open. This person has a difficult time with opening up to other people, perhaps showing their true self. And I feel like this person is saying that they're having a hard time opening up to you in particular because of the shadow. Spirit, can you tell us more about this aspect? Karma. So there's some kind of karma at play, some kind of alternate timeline. And in this timeline, there was a separation that happened, possibly because of loss. They may have lost you in another lifetime, and that's created a fear, and that is holding them back. There is a lot of this karma at play right now if you watch my other videos. Goddess of endurance, Persephone. So Persephone is the goddess of the underworld. And there's a healing from the divine feminine to the divine masculine happening now. And I feel like this card is saying Persephone is taking this person to the underworld in order to heal their ability to be more open with you and moving past this old fear. Persephone, because she's the queen of the underworld, also relates to grief as well. So that's another indication that this person may struggle to be open with you because of past life grief and death. And this card as well is telling me that this person is being activated by the solar energy right now to be more open. That's what's triggering this shadow aspect and this healing. What does this person want to say to you? The first message is, I feel the chemistry between us. We need to trust that the energy that we share will bring us back together again. So this may be a time where you are struggling to have trust with this situation, and the message coming through from your person is that they do feel the connection to you. And I'm getting that they feel you energetically very strongly, and also that this person feels in their heart that there will be a reunion with you. What else do you want to say to your twin flame? I'm feeling controlled by people around me and I don't like it. It's pushing me to find my power again. And if you didn't notice my voice, my throat chakra really went as I was trying to read that card. So I feel like that's a message from this person that they really have a hard time communicating with you. And it's because they're not in their power. It may not necessarily be that this person is literally being controlled by people around them, but they're being controlled by this karma in the sense that they're not standing in their power because they have this subconscious fear that if they get close to you again, they could lose you, or that you would in some way get hurt by their presence. So you can see this guy in this picture, he is not in his power. There's this woman angry at him and he is flinching away because of this subconscious guilt that he's carrying. And that's the same type of energy that I'm getting from this image. You might be frustrated with your person because they're not in their power. And you don't realize that it's because they have this really deep-seated subconscious fear. Let's get one more message. I've never felt love like this before. The depth of it can be inspiring, yet also overwhelming. So yeah, I think this goes exactly, and we have 2 8s here. I am filming this in August for Lionsgate. And again, I feel like your person, they feel this emotional and physical attraction to you. They know that there's a strong love here, but it sometimes gets overwhelming for them and they pull away, and you may not understand why, because they may pull away at really not appropriate times perhaps. I know it's quite common, for example, for one twin to be going through an illness, even a very severe illness, and their twin may pull away. And it seems like the most inappropriate time for them to pull away, but what you may not be realizing is your person has this really deep fear that they are going to lose you again. So much so that they couldn't take that and they completely shut down. So yeah, this feeling of overwhelm may be an issue. What is on their mind right now? So what is on their mind is, how can I manifest a more positive relationship with you? So they're trying to face these shadow aspects because they do want to change the dynamic of the connection with you. Deception. Yeah. So again, what they are showing you is not how they really feel about you. They're not able to be fully open with you. What song would this twin like to share to let their person know their feelings for them? Okay, the song is You're the One by John Lennon and Yoko Ono. Mountains may move, river may run, but you make me be myself. You make me be. How do I tell you? How do I tell you're the one? Stars may move, time may run, but you make me free myself. But you make me free. How do I tell you? How do I tell you're the one? In the world's eye, we were Laurel and Hardy. In our minds, we were Heathcliff and Kathy. In a moment of wisdom, we were wizard and witch. In a moment of freedom, we were Don Quixote and Sancho. In reality, we were just a boy and a girl who never looked back. So this person wants you to know that they feel like you are the one for them, and they're trying to figure out how to tell you. And they even say here, like, you make me free myself. You make me free. It's your energy that's pushing this person to free themselves from whatever their prison is. And it may actually, you know, this is called shadow aspect, but a lot of twins are facing not just an inner shadow aspect, but they're facing a kind of shadow situation or shadow relationship. So let's get an angel message here, and let's ask the angels for a message and some timing information about this situation for this person. A message and a timing information, please, for this person. Okay, the message is from Barakiel, Divine Angel of Blessings. This is a number 31 card. The key words here are showers of heavenly love, intercession, good fortune, removes blocks to success. I can help you become a generous channel through which God will pour a fountain of blessings into people's lives. The crystal is unikite. The timing is February and the message is opportunity awaits. Okay, so this is a really good card because Barakiel is coming here to say that she is helping remove blocks to success. So she is working with this person to clear up the shadow aspect. And indeed, there could be some kind of divine intercession happening on behalf of this person to help them through. Or it also says, right, showers of heavenly love. So they are really being guided right now by Source. And you may look for something to happen in February with this person. They may connect to you in February. You may hear from them, or they might be kind of free of this energy in February. So what can we know about what will happen in February? Playfulness. To recapture romance, allow your inner youthful spirit of fun to shine. So yeah, you could hear from this person, but this person is definitely going to be more lighthearted and more free in their energy by the time that February comes around. If you would like a personal reading about your situation, you can contact me at twinstrology.com. Go to my website, you can see what kind of readings I offer, and also past life regressions if you're interested in doing some past life work around these situations. Thank you so much, and I look forward to speaking with you again soon. Okay, if you chose card number 2, the message that your twin flame wants to tell you is God of Vulnerability. So your twin is feeling vulnerable at this time, and they're a little bit in protective mode. So they may not be as open with you at this time as they normally are. But this is like really where their energy is being focused. And although Achilles here, I started to say Achilles heel because that was on my mind. You know, remember Achilles, his heel is his weakness. But he does have his helmet off so that we can see his face. So I feel like there is progress here for this person as far as dealing with their fear of being vulnerable. Let's see if we can get more information about this. What else can you tell us about this fear of vulnerability? God of Obstruction, Ganesha. Okay, so this person has a block around this energy. There's something that they struggle to move forward with. It's protection, yes, but it's something else here too. What I'm getting is that they feel insecure about their ability to challenge the status quo in their life. That's what I heard. So they're really fearing that if they take a risk, they might fail and they might appear weak. What else can you tell us about this fear of vulnerability? Transcendence. Okay, so this is good. This person at this time is trying to overcome this fear. They're trying to overcome this blockage that they've had. And in what area of their life is this? Miscommunication. So it's like, well, I feel it's primarily in communication with you, but I feel like in general, this person has a difficult time communicating. It's like they often feel that they're being judged by what they say or what they talk about. Perhaps they have a hard time communicating their feelings. Just kind of like, in general, difficulty expressing themselves. Let's see what other messages they have for you to see if we can get more information. For some of you, there may have actually been an argument with your person, or you've butted heads in the past because there may be something that you don't see eye to eye on. I've talked about this card before. Like, one person sees a 9, one person sees a 6. They're both right. And that might be something that needs to be understood here, is that both of you are right. It's okay to have different perspectives, but it could be that your person, when they're faced with someone that has a different perspective than them, it makes them feel a little bit threatened, perhaps. And this is likely something that stems from a past life situation where they were persecuted for things that they were saying. What does this person want to say to you? I'm triggered. An old pattern had surfaced and it hurts. Okay, so this is interesting because this is telling us that something has happened recently that made this person feel triggered and feel like they have to go into this mode of self-protection. Now, with this transcendence card too, at the bottom here, she's all tightly wound up. She's very much in a stance like Achilles is, right? I'm protecting myself. And her energy wants to open up. So this person is like, they want to open up. They don't want to be in this kind of tight ball, closed up energy. But for a lot of people, this is going to be something that happened fresh. Although it's not something new, but there was some kind of fresh argument, disagreement, a different perspective that's happened that's triggered them. And they needed to be triggered because this is a block for them. What else do they want to say? I need to move slowly with this, but trust that I'm moving even when it seems like I'm not. So you may be a little bit frustrated with your person at this time because you feel like they're not doing enough, or you don't understand why all of a sudden this person pulled away or shut down. They may have like pulled away from you without any warning or just shut off communication. And so from your perspective, it's like perhaps you feel like they're going backwards. But this person wants you to know that they are moving forward. It just may appear from this 3D perspective that things are moving very slowly. I just want to say what is on the bottom of the deck at this minute. We are coming into union. So what else do they want to say to you? Our love is eternal. It exists in every dimension and cannot be lost. So again, no matter how this person is acting towards you, they know that this is an eternal connection and the love is never truly lost. And we have 11711, which is a very seven and ones. Numbers tend to, again, represent union energy. What is on this person's mind about you right now? So what they're thinking about is, what are this person's thoughts about me? Okay, this gives us even more information here, because they're thinking, what does this person really think about me? This person is feeling insecure about how you see them. In fact, if we just look at the image on this picture and we forget about any details, you know, like this person is being defensive. I don't know why I'm picking the man here in this picture, but so yeah, definitely this person feels like they are judged when they say things, and so they hesitate to open up. What else does this person want you to know about this situation? Keep an open mind. Your soulmate may differ from your usual type and expectation. So the other thing that they want you to know here is what I'm getting is that it's them that's trying to keep an open mind. And it could be that there's something very different about the two of you. You may have come from different backgrounds or different perspectives. And this person has had to open up their mind about your connection. It could also be that perhaps there's third party energy involved. And that is also had to help this person open up their mind. Let's see if we can get an angel message and timing card. Angels, what can you tell us here? Okay, the angel is Simeel, angel of unconditional love. Relationship repair heals broken hearts, tenderness, family unity restores harmony. I foster harmonious relationships by filling hearts with compassion and love. I also help soulmates unite. Rhodochrosite is the crystal, new moon is the timing, and the message is compromise. Okay, so if there has been a disagreement with this person, a compromise needs to happen. And, you know, I mentioned this other situation where maybe this person pulled away from you and they stopped talking to you, and maybe you're not even sure why. And what they want to say to you is that they are healing this situation and they're trying to reach some kind of compromise because they feel like they do want to reconnect with you. So we have this timing here of new moon. We just had the Leo new moon, and at the end of the month, we have the Virgo new moon. So there may be some shift happening If it hasn't happened already, it could be happening at the Virgo new moon. Let's see if we can get another card about timing. Angels, can you give us another timing card here? Or more details? Metatron, angel of divine presence, miracles, powerful change, Akashic records, sudden shift, spiritual growth, hyperfocus. I help you discover and develop your personal spiritual power and learn to use it to make a better world. The crystal is ametrine. The timing is 3 months and the message is act now. Okay, so I think what these cards are saying, what with Metatron's message here, is that anything can happen from now to 3 months. But let's see. So in 3 months' time, we're going to be in eclipse season. That's going to be November. And I feel like November is going to be very transformative for twins. And there could definitely be some sudden shifts happening. And I feel like this person is doing a lot of healing. They want to repair this relationship with you and perhaps even repair some other relationships in their life that aren't so great at this time. So there will be a Scorpio new moon. Let's see. Just looking at the planetary influences here to see if there's anything Scorpio. Well, that's going to be the new moon eclipse in November in 3 months' time. So you may want to just mark that down and see if anything shifts for you around that time period. Sorry, number two, I forgot to pull a song message for you. So let me do that now. Better late than never. I had already gone on to reading three when I realized that I forgot your song. Okay. So your song is Two Wrongs by Abso Facto. I know it's sad. Thinking about it hurts me every night. I know what I did wasn't right, but you got me back. You said something and I told you some lies, but I know two wrongs don't make a right. I know two wrongs don't make a right. I feel like walking away, so they keep telling me I need to stay. We should embrace you and I, cause love ain't no eye for an eye. We should not be falling out of love. We should fight for what is right for us. And I know it's sad, thinking about it hurts me every night. Okay, so this song really clarifies that this person and you have perhaps had an argument or disagreement, or just that one of you has closed off contact with the other one. And there's been some kind of hurt feelings, but they're saying like, yes, I know I did something wrong to you, but you also hurt me too. And we can't keep going on, right? The song is called Two Wrongs because two wrongs don't make a right. Someone has to come forward. And also there's this part, I feel like walking away, so they keep telling me I need to stay. Like this person, they did walk away. They ran away, but they know in their heart that they should have stayed, that they did the wrong thing, but they were afraid of appearing vulnerable. They were afraid of what you would think about them. But now they want to embrace it. And they don't want to fall out of love with you. They want to try and work things out with you. If you would like a personal reading about your situation, you can go to twinstrology.com, check out the types of readings that I offer. I do specialize in twin flame readings, but that's not the only type of readings that I do. So you can always email me with any questions as well. Sending you all a lot of love, and I'll speak to you soon. Okay, if you pick card number three, the message that your person wants to give you is grief and anger. So this person is really going through something right now. They may be very emotional, and there's some kind of feeling of loss in their life. I feel like for your person, there's a lot of kind of repressed emotions coming to the surface at this time. So let's see what other messages we can get regarding this. Okay, Mary Magdalene, goddess of strength. So this person is trying to find their inner strength. They're trying to find their inner balance. What I'm getting from Mary Magdalene is this person is going through a deep healing of the feminine energy, which is very much in the energy right now. I just need to take a closer look at this card, because I feel like this person is concerned about the future. I feel like this person is searching for clarity. So this is not really the cause of their grief, but it's like they want to find a way out of their grief, and they're trying to connect more with their intuition. But because of their emotional state, they're finding it a little bit hard. Let's see what else we can get about this person. Separation. And look at all these ones so far. 10, 1, 11. So 11, 11. So this person, they're feeling grief because of the separation that is happening with you. And they may be watching your social media, or they may be wanting to connect with you. Like, see, this person is holding their phone. It's like they look at their phone and they are thinking about connecting with you, sending you a message, but they don't know how, or they don't know how you're going to respond to them. I feel like they are the likely cause of the separation, and so they feel like regretful, or that you might blame them for the separation. Sorry, too many cards. One card, please, Spirit. Again, too many cards. What can you tell us about this feeling? Pachamama, goddess of forgiveness. So this person wants your forgiveness for the separation, or they need to forgive themselves. At any rate, they're feeling regretful about what's happened here. And it may not just be like, so you might be watching this and you might just think, oh, okay, well, I'll reach out to this person and that will take care of that. But it's not what this is about, because it's this Mary Magdalene card. This person needs to find their own inner strength, their own power. It's like they have to take this opportunity to follow their heart rather than being in resistance and fear and just staying stuck. You know, so when I was tuning in here before and I was talking about intuition, part of it is this person doesn't know how you're going to react to them. I'm also getting that for some of you, your person kind of sees you in this energy of what Mary Magdalene is here. Now, what I'm actually getting from this image is this image to me is the Delphi, the Oracle of Delphi. And I'm just gonna like not look at Mary Magdalene for the moment, because that's really what this image is speaking to me about, because she's wearing a red robe. She's in between these pillars. She's at an altar. This bowl here to me looks like a scrying bowl. So your person may see you as this very powerful priestess or priest, and they may be a little bit intimidated by you. They may wonder, will you forgive them? But also there's this other part of them that's trying to get in touch with their intuitive side, because they want to know how you're going to react. And yeah, they have to forgive themselves as part of their healing and part of their inner strength. Let's see what else they want to say. I want to say too, this person knows that they have done this to you. So while they're experiencing the grief and anger now, they also know that they have put you in a position where you have had to deal with a lot of grief and anger about the separation as well. Their first message is there's a lesson to be learned from this. Yes, absolutely. I've already said it. This person has to find their inner strength. It can't be that you reach out to them and you just make it all better for them. It has to be their obstacle to overcome. They have to become this powerful priestess or priest in their own life. And that's the lesson here. They have to follow their heart. And, you know, both of these goddesses, very heart connected and compassionate. What else do they want to say to you? Because of you, I'm starting to see what's really important in life. So they're having a change of heart, and the separation that you experienced might have been because this person was in resistance or... Okay, well, what I'm getting again is they weren't following their heart at that time. They were following more their mind. And they were trying to tell themselves that you were not important to them. And that they could just let you go and it wouldn't bother them. And they have found out since then that it does bother them. That you are important. And now they're worried that perhaps they've ruined it with you. Don't judge this, just surrender. I know it's triggering, but from a higher perspective, it's clearing energy and bringing us closer together. So I feel like there's been a lot of judgment about this situation on both sides of the union here, both the masculine and feminine. And there's been a lot of triggering this deep grief. And the message is coming through, like, just surrender to the situation. The situation is what it is. That's how it had to be. And it's actually bringing you closer together. And for a lot of you, you know, it made both of you strong. It made both of you learn how to forgive and how to be in this kind of unconditional love. So what kind of question is on this person's mind when it comes to you? How will this person respond if I share my true feelings toward them? Yeah, so this person is thinking about if they contact you, if they reach out to you, how are you going to respond? Are you still going to be angry with them? Or are you going to forgive them? This is a 44 number, so this is really what's kind of weighing on their mind right now. What other message do they have for you? Chemistry. There's a strong magnetic attraction here. So they're feeling that attraction. And like I said earlier, they thought that perhaps you weren't that important to them and that they could just move on. But no, they found out that they are feeling grief at your separation as well. Let's see what song message they would like to give you regarding their feelings for you right now. What is the song that this person would like to give you? Okay, the song is Never Tear Us Apart by INXS. Don't ask me what you know is true. Don't have to tell you I love your precious heart. I was standing, you were there, two worlds collided, and they could never tear us apart. We could live for 1,000 years, but if I hurt you, I'd make wine from your tears. I told you that we could fly, because we all have wings, but some of us don't know why. I was standing, you were there, two worlds collided, and they could never tear us apart. So I think that says a lot about this separation issue that this person is feeling. And it's like this chemistry, you know, there is this magnetism there, and this connection, it can't be torn apart. So let's get a message from the angels about this connection and a timing message if possible. Do the angels want to tell you about this card? So the angel is Makiria, divine angel of grace and truth, heart focus, grace, growth, light of truth, clean heart, honesty, trustworthiness. I reveal the path to God and will restore the divine light in your heart to show you the way. The crystal is ruby. The timing is March, and the message is take action. Okay, so the angels are working with this person to develop truth through God's grace. This person wants to be honest. They want to follow the message of their heart, and they will do that, I feel, but they have to kind of process these feelings of grief, and they have to forgive themselves. And I just want to say for some of you that this is something that is not just related to this lifetime, but other lifetimes as well. And this came up in reading number one, that there were difficult emotions and fears because of separation in the past. And so what that separation on other timelines does is it creates these subconscious fears that make people push the other person away, because they don't want to experience that loss again. And that could definitely be part of this story for you. And if you felt drawn to card number one as well, then I would say this definitely connects to a past life for you. So you might find that there's some shift happening with this in March. You may hear from this person in March. Let's just get one more message here, because we have this take action card. Barakiel. Okay, this angel also came up in reading number one. So if this reading is really resonating with you, you might want to watch reading number one as well. Divine angel of blessing, shower of heavenly love, intercession, good fortune, removes blocks to success. I can help you become a generous channel through which God will pour a fountain of blessing into people's lives. Unakite February opportunity awaits. Okay, so this message is really similar. This is actually card 31. This is card 32. And so February and March. So the timing here is very similar, as well as take action and opportunity awaits. So don't be afraid to take action. And especially if you are the twin that is feeling like you are who I am talking about, don't be afraid to take action, because there will be a positive outcome. This person is going to forgive you. And yeah, it looks like February or March. So you might just want to make a note of that. All right, thank you guys. If you would like a personal reading with me, you can visit my website, Twinstrology. I do specialize in twin flame readings, but I do other types of readings as well. I've been doing this for many years now. So check out my website. You can see what I offer, and you can also connect with me there through email if you would like more details about any of my services. Thank you all so much. I'm sending you a lot of love, and I'll speak to you soon.